Today, I'm going to talk about managing e-learning programs. Now, in e-learning, it can be in a very small scope. One person is doing a flash program. So you serve yourself as an instructional designer, a subject matter expert, and also instructional developer. And if you go ahead and implement that in your school, you will be an instructional implementer for that program. But if your school decides to open up e-learning courses for your students and they have money, so they may have to hire people like instructional designer will be designing the instruction, graphic designer will develop the graphics, videographer will do the video editing. You have people like multimedia specialists will do multimedia programming. And then you have lawyer may be looking into the policy, guidelines, and copyright, intellectual property right regulations throughout the country or overseas. There could be a project manager. There are so many people involved. It all depends on the scope of your operation. You can go from one-man operation to many-man operation. So today, we're going to go very slow, try to understand what is the process, how you go through the process, and who are the people involved, and what would be the responsibilities. I have developed this model called P3 model, which is people, process, and product. So in e-learning, in my book, I define two major parts. One is phase one, which is content design. Okay? Content design. Phase two, which is content development and delivery. These are very simple. It gives me a great pleasure to bring it easier to people this way. So you have a design. Remember I talked about architectural blueprint is the design of a house. And what is developed by the builder is the development. So delivery would be when house is ready, people can live in there. So I put that planning, design, planning analysis, design all in the design phase. Big phase, you're designing. When it's done, you take it to the class or somewhere. It's a development and delivery. These are the two major phases of the processes. Now let's see, who are the people? The people for the content design could be planning people. Remember, you have to plan for the learning. Design people and evaluation. Always think about the evaluation. It's not like a one-time thing. You do formative evaluation. How I do that? When I'm speaking in front of you, I ask this question. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? If I see your head nodding in the right directions, I know I am doing okay. I can move forward. If I see you have a little bit of, confused situation, then I try to go back and re-summarize, rephrase the thing. So that is like in instructional design, it's called formative evaluation for improvement. So evaluation is an iterative process. It should be done in every single moment. By opening up this dialogue, informal evaluation, we call formative evaluation for improvement. So you're continuously improving your product. Your design also. Let's see what are the people involved in the content delivery, content development. You have production people. That could include videographer, audiographer, video editing, programmer, multimedia specialist. Instruction support services will be needed for when you're delivering these flash programs. What are the support? Instructional support would include technical support, people who can provide laptop, knowledge about all the infrastructure. Then you have administrative support services too. Don't think that you're doing a flash and putting up there. There are so many people involved. Administratively, people will think about who will gonna do the scheduling, when things will be available, when would it be taken off the site. Then marketing. Marketing is the most single criteria for e-learning implementation. If you cannot market it, I'm not talking about you go to Kathmandu Bazaar and market it. No, you have to market it within your student. You have to market it within your institution. Marketing is the main feature of new innovation. There is a course that I took at Indiana. It's called Introduction to Innovation and diffusion. It means when a new innovation comes in, how to diffuse, how to implement throughout the places, you need a good strategy. You need actually good marketing. People, like I said, parents, they learn, got their degree by going to face-to-face classes. Now, you are telling them you can use the distance education course to get the same knowledge. Those parents' mindset, they would not accept that in their mind. So you have to change their mindset. And these people have to have a paradigm shift from their thinking that, yes, if you are taking online courses, if they are designed right, by encompassing the issues of learner, then it can be acceptable. To do that, they have to jump out of their closed system face-to-face instruction, traditional instructional class to jump out from there to a new paradigm of education which is open and distributed. Things can be done anytime, any place, and the learning resources can be located and distributed from different parts of the world. You see? So the marketing is single most criteria in many places, because if you do not get buy-in from your stakeholders, parents, community, and services, then you're not going to be successful. One time in Indiana University, during our doctoral program, one of the articles that we read, a professor named Robert Hynek wrote the article, in there, when this computer-assisted instruction, computer-based training started, the teacher, then teacher were thinking, if we use this computer-based instruction program, then we're going to lose our jobs. So they would put on the shelf, wouldn't use it. And I did my dissertation how to bring it back to teacher's hand, because they are thinking like that is going to replace me. But we try to convey the message through our dissertation. No, this is to complement what you do every day. This is to support what you do every day. Some of the things, computer can help you better. So when you release or you get some time from your busy teaching, you can use it for managing other things. So you need to do a greater marketing to convey the message of any innovative e-learning you're doing is not to replace you, is to assist you. You have to tell the community to change their mindset. How do you change their mindset? Show examples and non-examples. Example would be a places where a teacher is using it and students are having fun. They are liking it. You can provide examples that see they are learning. And also show they have gone through this computer program at the same time, their outcome was good, even better than face-to-face classes. So you can provide examples of good thing, then they will buy into the idea. And also show the example or non-examples, something not good. And that also help them to understand. So infusion of ICT. I am summarizing what I just said. There are people involved, and these people will have a special motivation. If they're not motivated, they're not able to take this innovation further. And you can say, how can I be a motivator? How can I be a marketer? Well, you don't need marketing training, but you know, like I said, examples and non-examples. If you can convince your student and you see the students are learning and positive outcome, that's a great marketing that you have done already in the U.S. Every institution, every program has public relations person who goes to community, got customer for us, students, you know. They do information sessions where you come in, they will tell you about the program, the benefit you can get, and look at the examples of competitors and how you're better than the program. These are the strategy in the United States they use. So in your culture, you know your people, you know e-learning is good. If you feel good, have fun, be brave, and bring it to people. Now the next one is product. What I do every single moment I'm doing something in my life, especially I'm thinking, what, I have an umbrella, right? I'll be doing this today. My goal, to protect you from the rain, and I'm gonna make sure with that umbrella I'm gonna take, I'll walk down there to the reception, should not get wet, right? If my umbrella is good. What kind of product that you have done? What is the outcome what you have done in this process where in the process of content design. So the product important. So the product would be, you develop the blueprint. So design process, you have the blueprint. How about the productions and delivery process? Well, you have developed the learning materials and you already delivered it, right? So simple mind, you know, you are in design stage, the outcome of that stage will be a design blueprint. Simple. You are developing an implementation stage, you developed it, now you're delivering it. So just remember P3, people, process and product. See the content development and content delivery. See the content development, you're planning. Who are the planning team? You need a good planner. That's why my model will help you planning pedagogically what you need, what technology you need, what kind of management you want to use, what will be your institutional issues. Based on that, you can plan for your course. My octagon should be used in a single page learning design to a learning university. So you go through all the octagon issues and see if you can come up with a good plan. So in the planning process, you should come a project plan as a product. You're sitting down, five of you, you're doing a planning. I will ask you, what's your plan? Give me your e-learning plan. So that will be your product for the planning stage. So each stage has a product. Design stage. So now you're designing. Page after page. Lesson plan. That will be a storyboard. That's the product. Production stage. Then you have developed the learning materials like Flash. Evaluation. So you're continuously doing the evaluation. Every time you did the evaluation, you look at the materials, it can be revised for improvement, right? So revised materials are the product of the evaluation process. Then, once it's done and you're happy, now you want to deliver it. So the finished product will be delivered, you have to throw CD or throw the internet. So far I covered who are the people, that's including the team, what are the major processes and what are the products. Let me show you the roles and responsibility. Your institution should come up with this kind of chart. Say that who would play what role during what stages and what their skill level. For example, you see planning stage, design stage, production, evaluation, delivery, and instruction means when you're teaching it. Also then marketing it. For example, role of instruction and designer. You can put the name of person. Then will he be working? Then you can go and put check mark on it. He will be involved in planning, design, evaluation. Okay? Then you can have someone else put the name instructor. So instructor maybe will be involved in planning stage and instruction stage. You may have a multimedia designer. He will be involved some in the planning stage because you have to ask him, can you do this in multimedia? So that person will be involved in planning and production stage. So you can list the name of the role that you need, like copyright lawyer. He will be involved during the planning because he's going to tell you what are the materials you can or cannot use. And I want to help you more like a hands-on if you need anything. But I do have something in here. This comes from these two books, references. And this side has a lot of material. Bookstoreit.com/framework. And it's my email. Thank you.